from the colonel.
Dear Master Cormac, my apologies for the brevity of this missive, but it is time we were honest with one another. You have demonstrated your loyalty and resourcefulness to the Templar cause. And this despite, and perhaps because of, your assassin origins. The manuscript the assassin sought has been in my possession for some time. I reclaimed it when my men found you marooned. The Grandmaster himself charged me to discover its meaning, a task I regret I have failed to complete. I leave it in your charge, Master Cormac. There is no one else I trust more. Now I leave for Fort William Henry, an ill-prepared garrison surrounded by hostile natives and the French army. We have requested reinforcements, but I doubt they will be forthcoming. I have no illusions that our resistance will be successful. I commit my life to the British Army, and my soul to the Father of Understanding. Yours, Colonel George Monroe.
Captain has the helm!
Mind your post, guest. The colonel's in trouble.
Trouble.
He's at Fort Wi- Henry, facing impossible odds.
Get off your lazy asses, lads, and man your stations! We raise anchor!
Sorry for the early libation, Captain. But do you realize that it's been a whole year since we met? A whole year! Changed my life, you did. And for the better. You will forgive me if I have been celebrating without you.
A whole year. Guest, I've a question for you. How long have you known of my, well, former allegiance?
Oh, you mean the assassins? I knew that ages ago, Shay. I may be drunk, but I'm not blind. Or did you think I would assume you had escaped from some homicidal circus?
Why didn't you say anything?
Well, the Colonel wanted us to avoid the subject so it wouldn't, you know, influence your decision-making. You saved my life out of pure selfless instinct and helped countless others besides. If it were up to me, I would have made you an official Templar months ago.
Who is it up to, then? Monroe mentioned a Grand Master.
Oh, yes. The Grand Master of a colonial rite. You'd like him, Shay. His father was an assassin.
Really? You must have a story to tell.
What is the news from Fort William Henry?
The garrison is surrounded, and reinforcements are late.
General Montcalm has been blazing a path across the colonies for King Louis, hasn't he?
I rather wish he'd stayed home with his mistress.
His or King Louis's?
Either. Though I suspect the King's is finer.
Indeed. Madame O'Murphy is supposed to be quite the charmer.
And O'Murphy is in the French King's bed. Now I know you're pulling my leg.
Shipping off a Seems there was a great demand for the colonies, for Fresco and for France. Well, the ship aboard the Limey barked the heart. And got legless drunk on my advance. How do you lay back? Taking your time. Take a turn around the Captain Nemo Paul. About ships, stations, boys, be hand. Without full up our eyes around the hall. Well, I joined her on a cold December morn. A flapping of me flippers to keep warm. With the south blown oyster as a warning. To stand by the coming of a storm. The paddy lay back, taking your slack. Take a turn around and get to me the ball. About ship's stations, boys, be handy. With alpha vapor rise around the hall. Well, I woke up in the morning slipping sore, boys. And I knew that I was outward bound again. And the voice came a-falling at the door, boys. The aftermen, an answer to your name. Paddy, lay back. Take in your snack. Take a turn.
Fire! Yes, goddamn! Toss the rise and toss!
Ready to
fire!
Wasting heat!
Ship's fire!
Yeah, they're all.
Hang tight!
Watch out for him!
I don't think he likes this, Captain! Sighting off the larboard bow!
Damn! Back to the ship, men!
It'll be ours another day, Captain.
Fishing off Haysborough Light, shooting and hauling and trolling on.
not in that windy old weather, stormy old weather. When the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
When up jumped a herring, the queen of the sea, says now, old skipper, you cannot catch me. Catch me in the windy old weather.
More sail! All sail!
Full sails!
As I walked down a Broadway one evening in July, I met a mate who asked me trade and a sailor to come. Said I, and it's the way you stand in, my dear Andy. Oh, you New York girl, can't you dance the polka?
To Tiffany's I took her, I did not mind expense. I bought her two gold earrings and they cost me 50 cents.
And it's the way you send me, my dear Andy.
Well, I anchored.
That's enough for now. Reef it all tops. Let out some sail.
Loose topsails, gallants and royals.
Cliff ahead, sir! Flotsam, sir. Could be valuable cargo. Floating cargo for the taking, sir.
Short sail! Get off the squall!
Away anchor!
Captain Cormac has the wheel!
Drop anchor!
C'est pas ce que j'aurais fait sans vous, cher monsieur.
Attends là.
Où est-ce que tu pourrais aller comme ça?
Arrête-toi! Oui, toi! Quoi là-bas?
Il va nourrir les corbeaux!
Je peux l'abattre d'ici.
Je le crois! Je peux l'avoir!
Viens essayer! Il est déjà mort!
Like rage, he shall haunt your dying corpse.
Surprise, but.
I'd rather fight a land war in Asia.
We need more cannon. We have to put them out of cover. Oh, yeah, I'm off.
Ah!
Your death is upon thee! That's the alarm! Your death!
Ugh. Sur la liste des avis.
Thank you.
qui ont réussi à attirer les Français dans la ville des
Mille. Franchement, ces conditions sont infernales.
Pourquoi ne pas envoyer des éclaireurs envoyer de drones notre ici.
Capitaine, je suis inutile. Personne ne va se rendre
jusqu'au bout de la nuit.
Captain is daft. I'm afraid we will not make it out alive. I'd rather fight a land war in Asia.
You know what I could use right now?
A barrel of powder.
Thank you.
Up speed!
Flotsam, sir. Could be valuable cargo.
We're on course to hit rock, sir.
Check the yards off the wind.
To the deep.
Douse all but mates. Trim us off the wind.
Anchor ahoy!
Jay, you are a sight for sore eyes.
Jack?
Colonel Monroe surrendered to General Montcalm. The French and their Abenaki allies took Fort Henry. Johnson was supposed to bring reinforcements here.
I don't see anyone else.
The Abenaki are restless. They don't understand the terms of surrender and refuse to heed Montcalm. The colonel and his men were released this morning. They're walking into an ambush.
Wait here in case Johnson arrives. I'll protect the colonel.
Thank you.
Maybe I can finally repay my debt to him. I hope I'm not too late.
Men.
Attack his flank.
That's the last of them.
Master Cormac.
Sir, we must hurry. We should bring what's left of your men to the Morrigan.
A welcome offer, Captain Cormac. Follow me. Safe passage is ahead.
If you don't mind me asking, what happened at Fort William Henry?
Poor planning and poor luck, I am afraid. Montcalm was able to bombard us for days.
Damn frog.
Actually, he acted with great honor. When we sent for Parley, he returned an offer far more generous than anticipated. We kept our arms, and more importantly, our colors.
Only to walk into a trap.
I would hardly expect the French to defend us. Would you?
No. I wouldn't.
You continue to prove your loyalty to the Templars, Master Cormac. Risking your life for me.
We're not out of the woods yet, Colonel. As for my loyalty, well, I do owe you, don't I? You saved my life. Gave me a second chance.
We have been working together for a year now. During that time, you have rendered many great services. Whatever debt you imagine you have towards me is paid, wouldn't you say?
Perhaps.
Take cover!
You keep together, men!
I'll take out as many as I can. Keep your men moving. I'll scout ahead and signal if there's trouble.
A sensible strategy. Very well. I will lead my men around slowly.